Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra and today I'm gonna teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. And please don't forget to subscribe, you have to subscribe it and hit that bell button if you want to receive some future notifications to my new videos and tutorials. Okay everyone, so you can see all my materials on the screen. You can see there the brushes, the 5 limited colors, and also the canvas that I'm going to use and other materials that we're gonna use for this painting or for this tutorial. Okay, so today I'm gonna paint just a simple landscape with a little river or stream or some trees, some pine trees, and a very misty background. So it will be, I'll just make it as fast and simple tutorial for everyone so that everyone can understand it, easy for us to learn. And I hope you get something out of this, and if you're painting, just follow what I'm doing and just have fun painting. Okay, so I'm going to start. First I'm going to do a little sketching using the number 12 flat brush and this umber with some white, make it grayish. I'm gonna put the horizon here on this part. Yeah, it will be a little center. Some trees here and some big tree here. Yeah, it will be in this part. I'm gonna put a big huge tree here, another tree here, and then on the center of these trees I'm gonna put a pathway. Yeah, just a pathway between these trees. Yeah, there. There'll be a tree here, another tree here, and a pathway in between those trees. Okay, another tree here, and here it will be a little cliff. And a trees here. I'm gonna put some trees there, and here I'm gonna put a yellow tree. Yeah, very very. I'm gonna make it a really really glowing tree. And here's some I'm gonna put another tree here. Yeah, and then some water reflections, and I'm gonna do my best to make this reflection as realistic as possible. Yeah, so this is my sketch and I'm going to start adding the colors. Okay. So here I have some white. I'm gonna make this a little lighter here. And everything, and I'm gonna use some blue. Yeah, blue and white. Yeah, I will now use good blue, yeah, without any mix. There. Okay. Another blue here. And some light blue on the set on the top. There, I'm gonna put a lighter color on this part here. Yeah, maybe I'll try to use a bigger brush. Yeah, you can use any big brush. I'm gonna use this one. Yeah. to make my work faster. There, it has a bad handle. You cannot blend. It's easier not to blend because we put the colors first. I need to refill some white on my palette. Sorry. Some white. I'm gonna put some white here on the bottom. We need to blend perfectly to make it look good, of course. There. I'm gonna use some more blue to make it darker. Yeah, I like that. It looks like an abstract. There. That's it. So it looks like we have an abstract background. Okay. So far, it's good. I'll just try to blend more, but I think this is good. I'm going to clean my edges. Okay, there you go. And now I'm going to try to put more, some blends here. Okay. Now I'm gonna start to put some darks. So again, this is just the what they call the underpainting. So everything here and just start just making the underpainting. So later I'm gonna put more details, but for now we're gonna do the underpainting. And here I'm using the umber first, using the big brush. There, and also here. And then I need to put also the background. So I need to put the reflection first with the reflection. So I'm gonna use again this one. Yeah, in painting the with the reflection, all you have to just copy everything you see from the top. So I see light blue there, so I'm gonna copy everything there. And I'm gonna use some white because I'm going to cover this cover the center here, and I'm going to paint it all the way here. because this is a reflection. All we see in the top, we'll put on the bottom. I'm going to make sure that I cannot see the okay, I'm going to use some blue color. So this part, I'm gonna make it darker. I'm gonna use more blue here. There. I'll just make this part a little darker. There. Okay. Yeah, and then I'm gonna use this again in yellow. I'm gonna put some greens. There. I want it a little darker, so I'm gonna put blue. Umber and yellow. Oh no, I mean yellow and the blue to make it greens. Okay, just yellow and blue, everyone. You can just cover here. Make it dark. I'm gonna put some grasses on the center. Okay, and then I'm gonna put more greens, yellow and blue. Here. I'm gonna put a little red, not just blue, to make it look more natural. And then we're gonna use this raw umber with white. This is gonna be our pathway. Thank you. through umber and white to make it gray for our pathway. Yeah, I like it. We all have to explain it here to make it look good. I'm gonna blend it so that we cannot see, so that we won't see any dark white backgrounds or something. Yeah, it's still wet, so maybe I'll just put some blue stone here. So just downward strokes to create those this initial reflection. This is not a reflection yet. Also here. There. Okay. Yeah, so we have now the first step. Yeah, I'm going to blue and yellow. I'll try to make it a little mountainous. There. So I'm gonna let it dry first for this 5 minutes, then we're gonna go back adding more details. Yeah. Okay everyone, so I think the paint is already dry now, and I'm going to start adding the details and the highlights. Okay, so I'm excited to put some more details on this painting. Yeah, I think it's really dry. Okay, so I'm gonna do it little by little. First, I'm gonna use this number 10 bristle flat brush. I have the blue and a little yellow. It should be more blue. And the raw umber. Yeah, I'm gonna put some dark tones here. I want this part to be look dark. And with some grasses, a little grasses. So yeah, you can use the tapping technique. There. I want to put more blue. Okay. And I'll put the big tree here. One huge tree. And also the other one here. But first, I'm gonna put a really bright tree here on this part. I will use yellow. Yeah, with a little red. I want it to be more orange. I want it to be more bright golden. So I'll put it here. You can use the tapping technique. I'm gonna use a plain yellow here. Okay. And then I'm going to use number one liner brush. Then this raw umber. I'll just use the raw umber. Yeah. Maybe raw umber with a little blue color. And white. To make it a little lighter. I will not put so dark color here. I'm doing the tree trunk. Make sure that the branches are all small. Yeah, I like this tree. It looks good. Okay. And now I'm gonna put, yeah, I think I'm gonna put tree here. But here I'm gonna put a little bright colors. I know I missed the trees on the background. So I'll be using more brighter greens. A little bluish, I think. It's too dark. I'm gonna put in white. Yeah. Yeah. And then I'm gonna blend it here. You can use the dry brush to make it a smoothly blend, and then you're gonna put a little reflection here. So reflection should be the same, but also it should be bright. There. Okay. And now I'm gonna put a darker color. So blue and yellow with a little umber. I'm gonna make it a little bluish. Okay, again, just use the tapping or punching technique. To create these happy little trees. So that Barbara said. Okay, yeah, and I'll also put some autumn trees, so yellow and red. here. I like those trees there. I need to put more on the tin on the top. I want it to be look dark. There. Okay, so I'm pretty little trees on the top of our this part. Okay, so far I like it, and then I would like to try to put some darker trees here, but I want it to be dark. It should be I want it to no there is no plant light striking this tree, so I want it to be dark. So I want it to be a little more bluish. Like those trees, dark little trees. There, and then I'm gonna put some big trees there. So I'll be using a bigger brush, which is the number 2 flat brush. I'll put one big tree here. Just one straight big tree. Another tree here. So I just used the umber directly, so you can use the umber directly, everyone, for the tree trunk. There. And then we're going to put the leaves. So I'm using this blue color, but I think I have no white. Blue and yellow with a little raw umber. Yeah, to make it dark, more blue. It is look like a pine trees. So you need to create a little curve upwards for the leaves. And also the other one. With the same pattern, and I'm going to put some tree trunk, branches, I'm sorry. Also, I'm going to improve the tree trunk. I'm going to make it a little bigger. There, it should be a little bigger, everyone. I will use the liner brush. So if you have the liner brush, it's better for the round brush because it has a longer bristle. So here you can start putting the branches. And then I'm gonna add another one here. It is a smaller one. There. And then I'm gonna use again the bristle flat brush. And then we're gonna do it like this way. There. We're gonna create the strokes a little upward to create the design of the leaves. This is a little pine tree. There. And then the other one here, I want to put a little more. Yeah, so far it's good. Okay, and then I will start to put some highlights, some few highlights for these fine trees. Yeah, yellow with a little white and red. I can do it like this way. There. You can use the tapping technique like that. Just put it on the top of the darks. Yeah. And also here. Yeah, don't put too much. And then I'm gonna put some white. Much white. There. Okay. And then I'm going to use the yellow with a little blue to make it yellow green. I want this part to be glowing. With yellows and green. I want it to be more yellowish or a little orange. I don't want to make it too green. Also this one. I want this part to be yellow greens. Okay, so now I'm going to extend one here. Still wet. Yeah. Okay, so before that, I think I'm going to add it. Gonna use this yellow. And I'm gonna make this part glowing. Just put it on the left side. I'm using the blood yellow. And just by using the tapping technique, we can make this part look glowing. Okay, and then I'll be using yellow and white. Okay. I need more yellow on my palette. Because this part, yeah, I'm gonna make it a little yellow. I'm gonna make this part glowing. I'm gonna make this part more yellow greens. There. And then in the center, I'm gonna put a bigger tree. I'm gonna use this number 8 flat brush. Yeah, I'm gonna put it here. And then another tree here. I'm gonna put another one here. Yeah. Thank you. This one is a little bigger. Okay, then I'm gonna put one by one using the liner brush. I'm gonna put some branches. Okay, and using this raw umber. So here, make sure that the branches are smaller compared to the trunk. There, and also the other one, I need to put branches. Okay, and then I'm gonna put, yeah, but first I need to put some blue on my palette. Blue, yellow, and a little red. More blue, it's a bit dark. Yeah. The lip should be solid because this is near to us, so the lips, we expect that the lips should be a little bigger. Okay, yeah. There. And then I will try to put a little yellow greens anywhere between this. Just a little yellow greens, everyone. To make it look like it got hit by this some little tiny some fraction of from the sun. Just a little. Yeah. And I will put more branches using the umber. Okay. Yeah, I think that looks good. And then I will start putting some highlights here. But first, I think I'm gonna put highlights on the pathway. Highlights and shadows. Yeah, I'm gonna make use this bluish color for some tiny little shadows. First, what are the shadows here? Well, I will extend the. This is the pathway. Some shadow, so I'm gonna make it a little bluish shadow. Need a little red to make it look more purple here. And white. Okay, now I'll try to put some colors on my pathway, so it should be, I'm going to put a little orange, because I want it to be glowing with the sun. Yellow and red. It should be brighter. I don't know, little tiny lights. Okay. Yeah. I think it looks good and very simple. So here I'm gonna put more yellow to make the ground more glowing. Yeah, just yellow and white. So here I'm gonna put more yellow. Okay, and I'll try to mix some purple. So I'm gonna put a little purple color for the shades, blue and red. Some parts are still wet, so it's hard to put there. Yeah, I will try to put more green, shades of green and purples. So here, I'll try to make this one dark. This part should have more darker colors like purples. And also here. I'm gonna put a little more purple here. There, and then I'm gonna use the liner brush. So I'm gonna do it slowly. Liner brush and white to create the details on the grasses. So I'm gonna do it a little one by one. Gonna create those grasses, beautiful grasses. And also some greens, we need some greens. We also need some orange. Yeah, you can do it one by one, everyone. Or you can use fun brush. Fun brush is good for this one. But this one, I want it to be more like grasses. Yeah. It should not be all grasses. We can also put other plants. Just dots of colors or white. Yeah, I can put more light colors. I want it to be really, really bright. Bright greens, yellows, a little browns. Yeah, there. And also here. I am using some brownie stones because I like these colors too. Also some yellows. I think I like the details here. It looks so great and looking really look realistic. Okay. Yeah, I will add more. Yes, of course. I will try these greens here. Light green. And I'm gonna put some grasses here. What I like about this brush is that I can create pretty tiny details. I'm gonna use some white. Yeah, this is the good thing about this brush, everyone. I can create a tinier plenty of details, especially these grasses. Okay. And this is just for one brush. I can create anything. greenish or some yellowish. Just one by one, everyone can create those tiny details of grass. Not just grasses, but also some tiny leaves of different kind of trees. I'm gonna use some white. So far it looks good. Okay, so yeah, I'm gonna put more. I'll try to, I think I'm gonna put some highlights on the trees, on the tree trunk. Yeah, I'm gonna make it I'm gonna mix some more orange, yellow and red only. There. Yeah. Just one strokes and you can create those beautiful highlights. And remember, put all those highlights on the left side. I mean on the right side, everyone, I'm sorry. But not everything, everyone, because some parts should be dark. I wanna put more red. And then I'm gonna put some purple on the other side, so here blue and red with white. Some little purple colors or a little bluish. Okay, there. Yeah, I'm gonna use this number 8 flat brush. I'm gonna use this blue and a little red and white. I'm gonna make this part, the pathway, purple. It should be more bluish, everyone, because it is contrast with the highlights here. Highlights is somewhat yellowish or orange, so it's good to look to be more opposite than the. It should be opposite and with the casting shadows like this one. So far I like it, yeah, it's good. And it looks realistic for me. Okay, so I'm going to continue adding more purples. So here, blue and red. I'm going to put some more purple here. And then some darker bluish for this part, for the grasses. But this part should be dark because there's no sun hitting this part here. There. Okay, now I'm going to add water reflections. I'm excited with water reflections, everyone. First, I'm gonna use this a little bluish tone with red to make it purple, and I'm gonna put it here. Cuff everything you see there on the top and put it down. And then I'm gonna put this reflection on this tree, so it should be the same, everyone. and also this one. But you can put the leaves there. There. Okay. Yeah, I think it's correct. Yeah, so far it looks good. Yeah, for me. I think this is very easy, everyone. It's very easy tutorial. And then also here we're gonna put our reflection. I'm gonna make it a little lighter. Okay, just follow what you see above and put it down. There. I'm gonna make it a little darker, greenish. I think this is just pretty easy, everyone. It's pretty easy and it's pretty basic. Okay, so I need to put more branches, I guess, for the tree there. I'll use this umber. I just want to put more branches on this tree. And also the other tree here on the left side. I think I need more branches. Yeah. so far everyone, I really like the result. It looks really okay, so I'll put more grasses and whatever plants we found there. I'm gonna use this blue and white, so the color will be more bluish. Just to put more grasses. Some grasses should be bigger. And also here, but this so far should be a little smaller. Some would be a little bigger and lighter. Okay, I will also put some orange there. I try to put this white and yellow. I want this to be really bright. Okay. think so far I like it, everyone. Yeah, it really looks realistic for me. Yeah. I'm not sure what I'm going to add, but I think I'm going to add more colors, yeah. Yeah, I'll try to put more. Orange for the plant on the left, so here, just yellow. Just put it on the top, there. Okay, and then this orange here we need to put on the pot for the reflections. We need also to put some reds on the reflections. Yeah. And then I'm gonna make this more orange, the pathway. Yellow and red. Yeah, it's a like a golden orange or rosena, everyone. If you have something like rosena, that will be good. So I'm not sure what else I'm gonna put there, because it's it looks good for me. Yeah, I'll just put some reds or whatever flowers on the ground, so to add more reds anywhere. There. And then I'm gonna make a little lighter on the pathway, so through umber and white with a little red. Okay. Yeah, so I think I am done, everyone. So I think this should be a pretty easy tutorial for everyone. And I think you can also do it. Yeah, maybe I'll wait a friend. I think I just to put more light here. Just a little light. I think orange. Yeah, just a tiny fractions of orange. Okay everyone, so I think I'm going to try to put more details here. Yeah, I'll just try to make this one make more plants here. I want it to be really huge plant. Okay, so that will be good. And for that I'm going to make this a little lighter. And I'll be using this brush. A little the number 2 flat brush. I'll try to put more blue and I think purple and white. I just want to make this a little more bluish. I'm going to add some blue and red to make some a little darker purple, and I'm going to try it here. Now I am on the right side, I am retouching part. Retouching everyone is one good part. And in finishing your painting, you need to retouch and you should know how to do it. This part I'll put a little bluish. A little light bluish color. And now a more reddish. And then here, I'm gonna put more reddish purple. Try to make this a little lighter. And then some blue and white. I'll try to make other parts more bluish. That's why I'm adding more bluish tone. There. Yeah, it's now light bluish there, purple something. Okay. So I am going to put some plants here, but I will be using a smaller brush. This one. And then I'm going to use this raw umber in white, just a little white, just to make it a little lighter. Try it here. you cannot barely see it, everyone, but I'm gonna make it a little bigger. And then I will start putting some a little orange color leaves. It will be some dried leaves there. I'll do some yellow and blue here. And white. There. I'll try to put some plants. I don't know why that happens to the cats, everyone. They are quarreling. Try to also to put some lighter I don't know what happened to the cats, but they are really shouting there. There are some lights here striking this part. Sorry, everyone. These cats are really nicey. Don't forget that this is the last part of this video. Just put more white. Now I'm gonna try to put more yellow, everyone. Let's make this brush a little lighter. Then I also need to put some there, and then I'll put some orange, and I'll wait for the tree trunk. I'll try to put more yellow. I think that looks better now. Yeah, so I think I'm done, everyone. So yeah, maybe I'll just put more here, light. I'll put more plants with bigger leaves here. Yeah, I think I like this. I'll just put some more yellow here. Just to make things look more glowing. Okay, so we need to do it one by one, everyone. Yeah. Then I want to put some tree trunk. Okay, so I think I am done, everyone. So far, yeah, I am contented with this one. So,
okay, everyone. So I wanna say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.